Thank you, Commissioner, and thank you for meeting with me earlier this year on what I'm going to talk about now, my pet project. And we keep bringing it up every year, and hopefully we're getting closer at this point in time. And that basically is, we pay for remediation of students that get college degrees, that high school degrees, that the amount of remediation is absolutely unbelievable. And when this discussion is, when we have this discussion, it's always, well, the urban schools, people have different problems, different issues, poverty, et cetera, et cetera. I was so pleased when I saw an editorial from Newsday, which doesn't normally happen, but what I was pleased about was that the high school graduation rate on Long Island, $22,000 a year average for each student. The Long Island, everybody complains about that gets too much state aid, except the Long Islanders, was graduation rate 89%, but only 54% of students got scores on their region algebra and English exams that indicate college readiness. Long Island. I know there's some better schools on Long Island, some schools that aren't so good. In Roosevelt, the graduation rate in 2015 was 72%. College preparedness, 3.3%. And the most noted high schools that are outstanding high schools, at least 90% did head off to college. About 70% of the community college students and 50% of the four-year college students in the state paid for remedial college classes to retake classes graduates didn't master in high school. And what I've been trying to do, and we've talked about it, is try to get some consensus between SUNY and CUNY and the Commissioner of Education and Education Regents, members of the Regents Board, a way to identify these students earlier. And rather than in the senior year, and everybody knows it happens, if you got your required courses, you're either in some type of study hall or you are allowed to go off to some phony baloney job that's supposed to prepare you for life. So I guess what I'm saying is I wanted to let everybody know that we've already had a meeting with the commissioner and the chancellors of CUNY and SUNY, and we're hoping to come up with some type of solution. But is there any comment you would, any brief comment you would like to make? And then I will go on to my next actual question.
Well, I appreciate your involvement of this and your support for it, because I do believe that we have a responsibility when a student has a diploma from one of the high schools in New York State that they shouldn't automatically have to go and take, and over 40% of them go and have to have remediation before they can take regular courses that matriculate to a degree, whether it's an associate degree or whether it's a four-year baccalaureate degree. So we have to stop that. And I've started having conversations early in my tenure with Dr. Zimfer and also working with CUNY. We believe that we can put in place an assessment that can be done in 10th grade that would allow us to know what areas particularly a student needed to have, and then provide that intervention in high school prior to a student graduating. You, and as you're aware, our conversation was that this would be something that should be done for every student that wants it, but that it could be an optional thing. But I will tell you, parents need to understand that we have a responsibility, as do they, in helping us to get their student where they need to be. And I would agree with you, if you look at the schedules, I believe across the state, we could make sure that our students, many, many more of them, were ready to go into college-level coursework when they walked out of high school. If we all agree, from CUNY, SUNY, and the independent colleges, and the state ed department, we can make that happen.
And if the parents learn about this and learn that they're going to save money, and their TAP grants aren't just going to get prepared for college while they're in college, I think parents would buy into it. And we as a state, we should make an investment to make sure it happens. The other thing that I started My first elected office was the school board of the city of Syracuse. That was 112 years ago, actually 38. And what seems to be happening more and more is that there is an atmosphere in the classroom that is, put it mildly, not conducive to learning. And that applies across the board to varying degrees to all types of school districts. And I really believe much of this stuff can be worked out by teachers teaching as long as they got an atmosphere in which to teach. We have violence in the city schools that, you know, teachers come to me all the time. I got struck. I got hit. The kid's doesn't get suspended, and he's back in my classroom or somebody else's next week, and there's no consequences. Now, I don't know if there's any statewide policy on that, but recently the Syracuse City School District was taken to task by our Attorney General, who indicated that there was some type of racial bias as to the number of suspensions. And they came up together, Schneiderman with his education expertise, and the city school district, what the suspension procedure should be, which resulted in there's nobody gets suspended anymore, okay? Very rarely. And you talk to any teacher in the school and the atmosphere is getting worse. So my question is there any statewide policy, rather than the Attorney General moving into the realm of education, where certain standards have to be met and certain things can happen if someone is breaking those rules with respect to how they should act in a classroom so there's a good atmosphere?
So I think your question actually has a number of different areas I'd like to address. First of all, our state school Safe Schools Task Force was made up of people from a number of different agencies, and we looked specifically at what we could do to support that, the whole concept of the climate of a school being better and conducive to an educational learning environment. That, you know, it's easy to say that, but to really get there, you really have to do, and I'm going to go back to it again, you have to do training across the board for teachers and administrators. And I want to connect that to another proposal that we have, which is to establish a office of community and parent involvement. We do not have a focused office on that, and much of what you've said connects to what happens with parents and students in the classroom and at school. So I think it's very important that we help and support schools across the state to have a respectful environment for students. One of the things that I do know, if students aren't in school, they cannot learn. If students aren't in school, they can't learn. It makes sense, but we have to often say that to ourselves. And there are a number of models that have been used to address the issue that you're talking about, which is, what is it you can do when a student is misbehaving that doesn't automatically have them exiting the school building, but rather doing other things? And there are many models that have been very successful. And part of the work that needs to be done, I believe, in New York is finding those excellent pockets of great work and sharing that with others. And the strategies that are used in school sites that have particular engagement of their students with their teachers, who have a relevant kind of curriculum where teachers are using the kinds of strategies in the classroom that get kids involved in it in a way that they have positive interactions with each other in a respectful way, that creates that kind of environment. And we are expanding to a school climate index. We believe that that's a really critical way of knowing how well students are interacting in that school. If the climate is a hot climate and it's not one that, and I don't mean, you know, a hot place, I'm talking about a hot climate where people are just ready to go after each other, then that is not conducive to a good educational environment. So we are instituting, as part of our Safe Schools work, a climate survey for schools so that we know and they know what they need to address to create that kind of learning environment that is conducive to an education.
Thank you.
You're welcome.